Hey everybody, Alex here, and in this video, I'm going to talk to you about our new online church platform. I'll talk you through how to use it, and I'll give you a little bit of heart and vision behind it. So if you don't already know, we have launched a brand new online church platform for our Sunday morning services. And in this platform, you can request prayer, you can chat, you can see the Bible alongside of it all. There's a lot of amazing tools here, but the point of this all is that we want to help you to engage with church online. So if you watch online, whether you're in the area or even if you're out of state, we want you to know that we absolutely consider you to be a part of our church. And so we want to act like it, right? We want to be able to pray with you. We want to be able to help guide you, interact with you, hear your stories, and do our best to walk alongside you through this thing called life. So this tool is going to be absolutely pivotal for you to be able to get the most out of your involvement at Rock Creek Church. Right now, more than ever before, we need community, digital or otherwise. So I'm going to show you how to use it both on a computer and on a phone. You can do it either way and they both work phenomenally. But first, I'm going to show you what it looks like on a computer. So you can get there directly by going to rockcreekchurch.org/live, or if you just go to our website, rockcreekchurch.org, the very first big button that you will see is Church Online. If you hit that, it'll take you right to this new platform. So what you'll see is you'll see a video with a play button. You can hit that, go ahead and start playing that. You'll see also a pop-up that comes up that'll prompt you to make an account. If you haven't made an account with this platform, that's okay. You can still chat and put in a placeholder name so we can see who you are. In the notes section, there's a little tab down here. We will in the future be hopefully putting out some sermon notes to go along with our messages. There is an embedded Bible, so you can just pull this up right next to the video and follow along. And I also really want to highlight this button right here, request prayer. If you click this button, it will pull up a private chat window with our hosts as well, with one host, and they will pray with you right then and there online. So that's an incredible way to continue to interact. And we want to push this for everybody, because part of what it means to be a mature Christian is to know that we desperately need prayer all the time. If you need prayer, please, please, please ask for it. I'll show you at the top, we have this menu bar with a handful of helpful links. You can get back to our website. You can view our kids' content. It'll show you a connection card if you're new or if you haven't given your information to us yet. This is a great way for us to be able to follow up with you and walk alongside you and help get you connected. There's also a link for past messages where you can find our YouTube channel and see all of our past services. And there's even a give button in case you want to give while you are watching our service. So that is a brief overview of what this platform can do. I'll show you my favorite of all is something called Moments. So this is something that hosts can actually do as they are watching is they can drop a link in there that's timely to make something really easy to interact with. So for example, if we really emphasize prayer in the service, the host can drop this right in there. You should have seen a big bar pop right up there for requesting prayer. If we talk about our YouTube channel, we could post this in here and give you a really easy subscribe link. Or especially moving forward, we are excited that if whoever's preaching decides to mention a quote, an author, or a topic that you may be unfamiliar with, that'll give us an opportunity to even drop a direct link in there for more resources. So as you can see, this tool is really powerful and can be really beneficial for the way that we engage as a church. Okay, now I'm going to show you what it looks like on a phone. So as you can see, it'll have that same prompt for you to make an account. And I'll say this, if you make an account, there's really not much to it. All it does is it remembers your name. You can upload a picture and make it a little bit more personal, and it helps us to interact with you even more. So we do encourage you to create a profile, but we can get rid of that. You can see that at the top, we still have that play button where you can see and view our services live. Underneath, we have the chat just as always. I forgot to mention this on the computer as well, but you'll see little things like a heart icon, claps for applause, giving an applause or even praise hands to at any point in the service live show that something's resonating with you. Everything's there, the notes the same, the Bible is all there, it's embedded, everything is here. And so we really want to encourage you, even if you are in our services, we are comfortable with you pulling out your phone and interacting live with the app, because then we get to continually strive for unity as a church. We are one church, whether we're here in the building or whether we're watching online. So that's our online church platform. We are really excited for it because it'll help us to be the church, not just watch church or even just attend church. We're called to be the church, and even in this digital age, this tool will help us to get there. So we love you, we're praying for you, and we really hope to see you on our new online church platform.